तुंडमहाकाय सूर्यकोटिसम प्रभ निर्विघ्नं कुरु मे देव सर्वकार्येषु सर्वदा। सरस्वती नमस्तुभ्यं वरदे कामरूपिणी विद्यारंभं करिष्यामि सिद्धिर्भवतु मे सदा। गुरवे सर्वलोकानां विषजे भवरोगिणां निधये सर्वविद्यानां दक्षिणामूर्तये नमः। ईश्वरो गुरुरात्मेति मूर्तिभेदविभागिने व्योमवद्व्याप्तदेहाय दक्षिणामूर्तये नमः। श्रुतिस्मृतिपुराणानां आलयं करुणालयं नमामि भगवत्पादं शंकरं लोकशंकरं सदाशिवसमारंभां शंकराचार्यमध्यमां अस्मदाचार्यपर्यन्तां वंदे गुरुपरंपरां। साक्षात्कृतं दयानंदं परमार्थस्वरूपिणं तत्वज्ञान प्रशास्तारं प्रणतोस्मि परं पदम्। ओम सहनाभवतु सहनौ भुनक्तु सह वीर्यं करवावहै तेजस्विनावधीतमस्तमा विद्विषावहै। ॐ शान्ति 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 की। ॐ पार्थाय प्रतिबोधितां भगवता नारायणेन स्वयं व्यासेन ग्रथितां पुराणमुनिना मध्ये महाभारतम् अद्वैतामृतवर्षिणीं भगवतीं अष्टादशाध्यायिनीं अम्ब त्वामनुसन्दधामि भगवद्गीते भवद्वेषिणी। नमोस्तु ते व्यासविशालबुद्धे फुल्लारविन्दाय तपत्रनेत्र येन त्वया भारततैलपूर्णः प्रज्वालितो ज्ञानमयः प्रदीपः प्रपन्नपारिजाताय तोत्रवेत्रैकपानये ज्ञानमुद्राय कृष्णाय गीतामृतदुहे नमः। सर्वोपनिषदो गावः दुग्धा गोपालनन्दनः पार्थो वत्सः सुधीर्भोक्ता दुग्धं गीतामृतं महत्। वसुदेवसुतं देवं कंसचानूरमर्दनं देवकी परमानंदं कृष्णं वंदे जगद्गुरुं। भीष्मद्रोणतटाजयद्रथजला गांधारनीलोत्पला शल्यग्राहवती कृपेण वहनी कर्णेन वेलाकुला अश्वत्थाम विकर्णघोरमकरा दुर्योधनावर्तिनी सोतीर्णा खलु पाण्डवैरननदी कैवर्तखेशवः पाराशर्यवचः सरोजममलम् गीतार्थगन्धोत्कटम् नानाख्यानकेसरं हरिकथा सम्बोधनबोधितम् लोके सज्जनषट्पदैरहरहः पेपीयमानं मुदा भूयाद्भारतपङ्कजं कलिमलप्रध्वंसिनश्रेयसे मूकं करोति वाचालं पङ्गुं लङ्घयते गिरिं यत्कृपार्थमहं वन्दे परमानन्दमाधवम् यं ब्रह्मा वरुणेन्द्ररुद्रमरुतः स्तुन्वन्तिर्व्यैस्तवैः वेदैः साङ्गपदक्रमोपनिषदैः गायन्ति यं सामगाः ध्यानावस्थिततद्गतेन मनसा पश्यन्ति यं योगिनः यस्यान्तं न विदुःसुरासुरगणाः देवाय तस्मै नमः नारायणं नमस्कृत्य नरं चैव नरोत्तमं देवीं सरस्वतीं व्यासं ततो जयमुदीरयेत्। Number 59 can repeat Vishaya Vinivartante
Vishaya Vinivartante
Niraharasya Dehinaha
Niraharasya Dehinaha
Rasavarjam Rasopyasya परं दृष्ट्वा निवर्तते यत्पि कौन्तेय पुरुषस्य विपश्चितः युक्त आसीत मत्परः वशे हि यस्येन्द्रियाणि तस्य प्रज्ञा प्रतिष्ठिता यतः Yataha is equal to yasmat. Therefore, tasmat. Yataha. Yasmat. Because this is so, what? Indriyani pramatini. Manaha prasabam haranti. Therefore, because the indriyas take away the mind. Therefore, tani sarvani sayamya. This rasa, that is the raga, rasavajam rasopyasya, the raga goes away only in the wake of jnanam. The knowledge happens, then only the raga goes away completely. And the raga will go only when the person does nididhyasanam. Because there are habitual mistakes, errors are there. That has to go. Therefore, nididhyasanam is important. Shravanam and mananam. With Shravanam, the person understands, and by Mananam, the person removes all the possible samshaya, whether it is regard to Pramanam or it is Prameya, the object of knowledge. So after Shravanam, Mananam, the Rasa will remain. The rasa, because of the purva samskara, the vasana, that will remain. That has to go. Only when that goes away, then the prajna will become sthita. For that to go, nididhyasanam is important. And therefore, this shloka says, since the indriyani pramatini, therefore, tani sarvani sayamya, yuktaha, referring to that person, the purushaha, who is endowed with viveka, viveki purushaha, yuktaha, samahita chittaha, yuktaha, who has got that samahita chitta, the focused mind, who has got that viveka. Only when he has viveka, then only he can, with focused mind, sit and do nididhyasanam. So that person, yuktaha asita, may he do nididhyasanam, contemplation, matparaha, that contemplation may he do, tani sarvani sayamya. Tani sarvani referring to indriyani. Sanyamya. Having managed all the indriyas, may he sit and do nididhyasanam. Only when indriyas, vashehi esyendriyani, vashehi esyendriyani tasya prajna pratishthita. Only when the indriyas are under one's management, is prajna only will be sthita. So therefore, having restrained all the sense organs, one should remain focused, concentrated and committed to me, matparaha. Committed to me, and I should be the highest goal for that person. May he committed to me as the highest goal. Paraha. Mat paraha. Because the knowledge of the person becomes steady. That knowledge, because the person whose sense organs are under well controlled, only that person's knowledge will be steady. Therefore, tani sarvani asita iti. This shloka says, we have seen the simple meaning. Mat paraha मत दट इज अस्मत दट इज आई एम अहम अहम एव परः यस्य आई अलोन इज दि परः दि हाईएस्ट फॉर दट पर्सन इट मीन्स I am Paramatma, the one for whom I, the Paramatma, is the highest. So, I refers to the Paramatma. So, Paramatma, Ishvara. So, Ishvara is the highest, is important for that person. He is committed to Ishvara. He is committed to gaining the knowledge of Ishvara, who is not different from Jiva. Therefore, the difference is because of this Abhimana, this Upadhi Abhimana, and this Upadhi Abhimana is habitual. Therefore, that indicates Nididhyasanam. So therefore, one has to bring in Ishvara always in his mind. And here Bhagavan uses the word aham mat paraha, because I, the pratyak atma, the one who resides in all the beings, I not limited to this upadhi, I the jagat karanam brahma ishvara, who is the antaryami of all the jiva. So let the person be committed to me, and I am not different from Paramatma. Paramatma is not different from me, and I am you as Antaryami. Therefore, let him be committed to me. So, therefore, committed to me is Nididhyasana. Matparaha. So, here Matparaha referring to not the Nirguna Brahma Vasudeva, that Krishna. Here it's referring to It doesn't refer to Saguna Brahma. Saguna Brahma, that Vasudeva Krishna. It refers to Nirguna Brahma, that Paramatma, that Ishvara. Krishna, as a person, he has got the Shariram. So, Mat Paraha, the Mat doesn't refer to the Krishna, who is the son of Vasudeva. Therefore, not Saguna Brahma. Here Bhagavan equates himself to Ishvara, Paramatma. So, Nirguna Brahma. So, therefore, Matparaha refers to Nirguna Brahma. The same Paramatma, when it is visualized with a form, that is Saguna. So, Krishna with a form is Saguna. Krishna, who is everything without form, all the forms are included in whom, is Nirguna. It means Shuddha Chaitanyam. So may he committed to me, the Shuddha Chaitanyam. That is the Lakshyartha of the word Mat, Aham. Even in the Mahavakya, Tat Tvam Asi. Tat Padartha. Lakshyartha of Tat Padartha, Tat, referring to the Chaitanya. Similarly, Tvam, when we say, it doesn't refer to you with this, you means you not with the Upadhi, minus Upadhi. So, you have to take the Lakshyartha, not Vachyartha. Vachyartha, if you take you means generally we understand with the Upadhi, the Sharira Upadhi. Therefore, by doing Bhagatyaga Lakshana, Jagal Ajagal Lakshana, so you means you, the Lakshya, you is the pure Chaitanyam, the Shuddha Chaitanyam. Similarly, Tat Shuddha Chaitanyam. How many Shuddha Chaitanyams are there? There is only one, and that is Atma Brahma Chaitanyam. That is Matu. That is the meaning of the word Matu. So, therefore, Matparaha, one should see oneself as Chaitanyam, which is the Tattvam, the truth of Jiva and Ishvara. This is how one should do Nididhyasanam. Nididhyasanam as Agam Purna Atma, Agam Akarta Abhokta Atma, Agam Sakshi Atma, Agam Asanga Atma, Jagat Karanam Brahma, that Brahma is Agam Eva. And I am not limited by this Upadhi. In spite of this limited Upadhi, I pervade everything. Because of me alone, everything is. Everything is born out of me, everything is sustained in me, and everything finally resolves in me. That is how one should do Nididhyasanam. The Matparaha, the word Matparaha, denotes Nididhyasanam. The person has to do Nididhyasanam. By doing Nididhyasanam, this Sharira Abhimanam, the Abhimanam with regard to Shariram, not only Shariram, anything that connected through Shariram, all this will be dismissed. So only when this happens, then only Raga goes away. Only when Raga goes away, then only Sthitas, the Pragya will become Sthita. And for that, the first thing is Indriyani Sanyamya. Indriya Sanyamanam is important. Managing the sense organs, that is Dhamma. Shama and Dhamma. So therefore, Bhagavan Krishna says, Tani Sarvani Indriyani Sayamya Iti. Now we will read the Bhashyam. Tani Iti.
Tani Iti.
Tani Iti.
Tani Sarvani Sayamya.
Tani Sarvani Sayamya.
Sayamanam Vashikaranam Krutva. युक्तः समाहितः सन् आसीत
आसीत
मत्परः
मत्परः
अहं वासुदेवः सर्वप्रत्यहात्मा परः यस्य सः मत्परः अहम
वासुदेवः
How to do Nididhyasanam? Aham Tasmat Paramatmat Paramatmanaha, not Paramatmat, Paramatmanaha. Aham Paramatmanaha na Anyaha iti. Paramatma Paramatman Paramatmanaha Anyaha na iti. So Tani Sarvani Sayamya Tani. Referring to Indriyani, Indriyani Sarvani Sanyamya, Sanyamya is Sanyamanam Vashikarnam, Sanyamanam is equal to Vashikarnam Krutva. Having done the Sanyamanam, that is Vashikarnam, having accomplished the mastery over the sense organs, having accomplished the mastery Vashikarnam. Vashikaranam is mastery. Yuktaha. Yuktaha is samahitaha san. Yuktaha, the word from the Yujdhatu. Yuj has got the meaning samadhu. Samadhu. So, samadhi is focus. Samadhi is not Nirvikalpa Samadhi. Samadhi is focus. focus of the mind. The mind is focused on only one thing. Focused on only one thing. It is not scattered by the pull of the sense organs. Each sense organ will bring its corresponding sense objects. If raga is there, if purva vasanas are there, some taste for that rasa is there, then the mind through sense organs will go in all directions. That should not be. Therefore, ittaha samahitaha san. Therefore, the person has got the ability, the capability to focus, has got the commitment, the ability to focus the mind on himself. So he has got the ability, he has got the capacity to focus on the topic. When he does Shravanam, he is focused only on the listening, not anything else, not other thing doesn't matter. Similarly, with regard to Nididhyasanam. When he does Nididhyasanam, all the sense organs are Sayyamanam Vashikaranam Krutva. Therefore, Asita, may he sit. Asita, one should remain. The person must remain. Asita Vidiling. May he remain Matparaha, committed to me. Committed to me. Matparaha. Aham Vasudevaha. I Vasudeva. Vasudeva is Vasudevasya Apatyam Puman Vasudevaha. The son of Vasudeva is Vasudeva. But here Bhashyakara takes Vasudevaha is equal to Sarva Pratyahatma. Sarvaha Pratyahatma. Vasudeva is not Vasudevasya Apatyam Puman here. If you take it refers to the Shariram of Krishna. Sharira, body, mind, sense complex of Krishna, who is the son of Vasudeva. That is not here, Vasudeva is. Here Vasudeva is Sarva Pratyahatma. Pratyaksha Aso Atma Pratyahatma. That is the Atma, the individual, that Antaryami, the Chaitanyam, who is Krishna, who is Vasudeva. Vasati Nivasati Sarvasmin Sarvabhuteshu Iti Vasuhu. The one who dwells in every jiva, every being as Antaryami is called Vasu. And the Vasu, his nature is Jyoti Swarupam. Therefore, Devaha Divyati Iti Devaha Divyati. So, Vasuscha and Devaha. Devaha means Jyotihi. Jyotihi, the light. What is that light? Chaitanyam is the light. Chaitanyam is that which illumines everything. So, that Antaryami, that Chaitanyam, that is Vasu, Vasuscha Asau Devascha. It is the Deva. It is the light. Vasuscha Asau Devascha Vasudevaha. So Vasudeva means the consciousness, the Chaitanya, which is dwelling in all the beings. Therefore, Vasudeva, the indweller, Antaryami, therefore Pratyekatma, and Paraha. Paraha means highest, Pradhana Purushaha Paraha. So, Vasudeva is Paramatma. Yasya Saha, for whom Vasudeva is Paramatma, then therefore Matparaha. Matparaha is a Bahuvrigi Samasa. Mat referring to Vasudevaha, that is Aham Vasudevaha, Sarva Pratyahatma, Paraha Yasya Saha, for whom I, the Vasudeva, the Paramatma, is the Paraha, the highest, the goal of life. Saha, that person Vasudeva is the highest goal. Is the only goal. He doesn't have any other goal. So moksha is the only goal. Therefore indriyas, therefore it is implied that indriyas are under his management. So therefore, matparaha, therefore, let him do nididhyasana. How? Aham tasmat na anyaha. Tasmat means not therefore. Tasmat referring to paramatmanaha. Vasudevat aham na anyaha. I am not different from Vasudeva. I am not different from Lord Krishna. Lord Krishna is Nirguna Brahma Krishna. Chaitanyam, Shuddha Chaitanyam. I am not different from that Paramatma. I am Paramatma. Aham Jagat Karanam Brahma Ishvaraha Paramatma. Let him do Nidhyasanam in this way. That is Matparaha. Iti Asita. May he remain seated. May he do contemplation this way. Iti Artaha. Ityartaha. Iti. So, it is not that he should sit and do contemplation. It is not sitting and doing Nidhyasanam. Nidhyasanam is his life. All the time, he has this thought only, this contemplation only. While walking or eating or while sleeping, always there is an appreciation of the oneness between this individual and the total. So, it is not doing the japa of Mahavakya. It is understanding the Mahavakya at every moment, in spite of action. At every action, he remembers his Mahavakya. So that whatever Abhimana comes, that Abhimana is a Pratibandha. That Pratibandha he removes by this Jnanam. This is Jnanam, and that he removes by this Jnanam. That is Nididhyasana. So that is the meaning of this Vakyam. Therefore, the next line. Evam.
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 Asinasya.
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 Yatehe.
Yatehe.
Vashehi yasyendriyani.
Vashehi yasyendriyani.
Vartante.
Vartante.
Abhyasabalat.
Abhyasabalat.
Tasya prajna pratishtita.
Tasya prajna pratishtita.
Evam asinasya yatehe. Yati means sannyasi. So, whoever is attempting, striving to get this jnanam is a sannyasi. So, evam, because yati means yatana, the prayatana is involved. Prayatana means the commitment and therefore the effort is focused. Therefore, it's a sadhaka. Iti means sadhaka. So, evam asinasya, for the one who is remaining in this way, kaha etehe asya, that is sadhakasya, vashehi, vashe means in. Vasha means in management, in control. Vashehi, yasya vashehi, under one's management, this indriyani vartante, indriya remains under one's management. Indriya remains under the management of yasya yatehe. Yatehe, how? Abhyasa balat. Abhyasa is practice. Abhyasa balat. Bala is the strength, by the strength of abhyasa, the practice. So, when the person does Nididhyasanam continuously, then The balam of that Vidyasanam, the balam of Vidyasanam will give more, managing possibility of Indriyas. Therefore, only the rasa goes away, they said rasa goes away only when Vidityasanam is done. So he will have more managing capability on his sense organs. When this is not done, Indriyas overrule because of rasa. Therefore, abhyasa important. So abhyasa, dainandina abhyasa, everyday abhyasa. It's not once in a while. Everyday abhyasa, dainandina abhyasa, because nididhyasanam, it's an important sadhanam. If the person is adhikari, sadhana chatushtaya sampanna, shravana matrena, jnanam siddhyati. But the pratibandhas are there. Therefore, the jnanam after shravanam, you cannot say, I don't have jnanam after shravanam. Jnanam is there, but the jnanam is sapratibandha jnanam. The jnanam is with obstacles. Therefore, for the jnanam to be well established, the jnanam sthita, the jnanam to be well established, so that the person is not carried away, by the rasa and the force of the sense organs, Nididhyasanam is important. Nididhyasanam is required to convert the jnanam gained through shravanam into sita prajna. Therefore, for prajna, to be studied, Nididhyasanam is important. Because that viparyaya, this, for removing viparyaya, nididhyasanam is required. And nididhyasanam also can be done in the form of continuous listening. Continuous listening, keeping oneself always committed to shravanam, that is also nididhyasanam. Nididhyasanam is this listening, continuous listening, so that the mind is not diverted, not shifted to in any other topic. So, tat katanam, tat chintanam, thinking about that only, talking about that only, all the time, that is nididhyasanam. That is, you are connected to this all the time. You are not away from this knowledge at any point of time. So, that is nididhyasanam. So, nididhyasanam is bringing the mind to the teaching. The teaching that has been gained through shravanam. So all the time it is kept alive, kept in mind. That is vidyasanam. That gives the alertness. So you are not carried away. You are not carried away by the force of the indriyas, the clamor of the sense objects. So nididhyasanam is important. Therefore, when it is there, then tasya prajna pratishthita, this prajna will be pratishthita, well rooted, well established. That is, he will not be carried away. After that, he will not be carried away by sense objects, by sense organs towards the sense objects. Because raga is not there, raga is overpowered by his jnanam. Therefore, pratishthita satapragna iti. Now, we can read this Shankaranandiyam. I will read and explain. For the previous shloka also, it is very beautifully yes given. But I forgot to read for those shlokas. Anyway, from this shloka, we can see. Here it says, Kani iti. Vishayeshu punaf punaha dosha darshanena. Dosha darshanam seed defects. seeing the defects in the vishayas, sense objects, punapunanda, again and again, so that you are not carried over by the pull of the sense organs, the attraction of the sense objects. Therefore, dosha darshanam, seeing the defects. Seeing the defects means seeing the limitations of the sense objects which the sense organs want to enjoy, because it is anityam, it is not tritikaram, and it is dukkha mishrutam, it is always mixed with dukkham. These are the doshas. So punah punaha dosha darshanena bandhakatva bhayena, fear of bandhaka, bandhakatva, fear of binding cha raga dvesha abhyam viyojitani tani indriyani sarvani sanyamya. Therefore, ragadveshabhyam viyojitani tani sarva tani indriyani sarvani, all the indriyas which are yojitani, which connect the person to through ragadvesha, sarvani sanyamya teshu pravrtim niruddhya. So pravrti towards engagement towards that niruddhya, restraining that, tattat golakesha sthapayitva, keeping the sense organs in their respective places. Tattra golakeshu, golaka is a physical organ. Indriyas are that which function behind the golaka. So golakeshu itself sthapayitva, make the sense organs remain in the golaka, don't let it go out. Sthapayitva brahma vidyati vidyater yuktaha. What is brahma vidyater yuktaha? You have to see the word properly to understand. Brahma vid yatihi yuktaha. Sthapayitva brahma vid. The knower of brahma. Brahma janati iti brahma vid. Brahma veti iti brahma vid. One who knows brahma is a jnani. Brahma vid is equal to yatihi yuktaha. Yuktaha, that is the person who has got the samahitaha chittaha yuktaha, who has got viveka yuktaha, is brahmavit yatihi yogena yuktaha samahita chittaha. Is yuktaha, is together because of yoga, is together because of yogena yuktaha, karma yogena, upasana yogena, is now together, is not, his mind is not split. His mind is also in Vedanta, and is therefore his sense organs are also with himself. Therefore, samakita chittaha vrittehe brahmakaratam apadya ityartaha, apadyeti ityartaha. So vrittehe brahmakaratam apadya. Apadyeta, that is the vritti, because it's samakita chittaha, therefore the vritti is vritti, may the vritti be brahmakara vritti. Let it not entertain any other vritti, that akandakara vritti, the brahmakara vritti, apadyeta iti arthaha. Apadyeta, let him entertain or let him gain this brahmakara vritti. What is the vritti? Matparaha aham eva paraha paramatma iti parasmin eva brahmani agam dihi yasya saha matparaha sarvam idam agam cha brahma eva iti sarvam svam cha brahma eva pashyan asita. Matparaha aham eva paraha, I alone the highest, paramatma iti parasmin brahmani eva agam dihi, in that param brahma alone, the dihi, the buddhihi, the one who buddhi is, whose buddhi remains, yasya saha, that person is matparaha. Sarvam idam agam, everything is myself, aham cha brahma, I the brahma, eva iti, sarvam svam cha brahma eva pashyan, everything is looked upon as myself. Sarvam svam and brahma eva, everything is me and that is brahma. Pashyan, seeing seeing, appreciating this. This is the satyam, the truth. So one should see that, seeing asita, let him remain. That is Nididhyasana. Pratyak drishtya sarvadat tishtat tishtat ityartaha. Tishtet, tishtet ityartaha. So pratyak drishtya, the drishti is pratyak drishti, atma drishti. Atma drishtya sarvada, let him tishtet, let him remain. Ityartaha, that is the meaning. Evam nityam nirantaram, nirantaram, no gap, nityam always. Pashyataha, the one who sees. Yasya yatehe indriyani, yasya yatehe sadakasya indriyani, vishaya vishaya graha anavakashataya. So there is no avakasha for vishaya grahanam. There is no space for vishaya grahanam. So tasya yasya yatehe indriyani niragani bhutva. There is no raga. Niragani bhutva, free from raga, having become free from raga, dvesha, vashe, vashyani bhavanti. Indriyani vashyani bhavanti. Indriya becomes obedient, slaves. It comes under his control, under his management. It doesn't disobey vashyani, that is a vashyam. Tasya khalu prajna pratishthita nishchala bhavati mokshasya siddhyati na eva itarasya iti arthaha. For him alone this prajna is pratishthita. The prajna will become steady. Nishchala bhavati, become steady. Mokshasya siddhyati, moksha also will, he will accomplish. Only when the prajna becomes steady, then moksha is gained. Na eva itarasya ityartaha. Otherwise not possible. That is the meaning. Iti Shankaranandiyam beautifully says. Then, nanu indriyaihi antakaranam visayeshu patitam chet anena asya vidushaha kova anartaha iti chet visaya abhidhyanam eva sarvan sarva artabijam. Nanu indriyaihi antakaranam. Antakaranam visayeshu patitam. Along with the indriya, the antakaranam, if it is patitam, if it flows towards the vishaya, the sense objects, chet, then anena, by that, asya vidishaha, for that vidishaha, vidishaha means jnani. Jnanihi. So, that jnaninaha, kahava anartaha iti, what is the anartha for iti chet, vishaya abhidhyanam eva, that is vishaya abhidhyanam, abhidhyanam eva sarva anartha bijam. What is the seed for sarva anartha? That vishaya abhidhyanam, diverting the mind towards the vishaya, letting the sense organs toward the vishaya, that becomes a cause for all the problems. Sarva anartha bijam iti. Therefore tena anartha hetu parampara. By that, there is a anartha hetu parampara. There is a cause for anartha hetu parampara. Tena anartha hetu parampara. That becomes the hetu for the anartha parampara. Apadati, that befalls the person. What is that? That he says, the next shloka is going to come. Father, he is giving an introduction. So, by that, paravaraikatva vijnanam vinashyati. So if the indriyas are allowed, if the indriyas overpower the person, then what will happen to the person? That vishaya abhidhyanam eva sarvanartha bijam. And if the vishaya abhidhyanam, that is, if the sense organs confront the sense object, that is called vishaya abhidhyanam, abhimukham, facing the sense objects, letting the sense organs face towards these sense objects, that becomes the anartha bijam for the anartha parampara. How he says, taya, by that, what happens is, by that is, taya referring to that vishaya abhidhyayanam, which is anartha bijam, because of that, taya, paravarekatva vijnanam vinashyati. The jnanam which has been gained, paravara, paravara, you can remember, Mundaka Upanishad, paravara, parasmat, parasmat. The jnanam which has been transferred from parasmat, parasmat, avarena, avarena, shishyena, shishyam prati, agachati. That jnanam, the jnanam which comes through the tradition, that jnanam vinashyati, the jnanam, that is, that shravana jnanam, the jnanam which has been gained from the teacher, the jnanam vinashyati, the jnanam is destroyed. Because the person is now committed to sense objects, enjoyment of the sense objects, because of this vishaya, vishaya vidyanam, vidyanena, paravijnanam, paravareikatva vijnanam vinashyati. Therefore, when the jnanam goes away, what happens? Tannashat jananavarna tarangamalini sansarabdho patitva svayamcha vidvan vinashyati iti. Therefore, tannashat, because of the destruction of that jnanam, what happens? The person, patitva, having fallen into the samsara, samsarabdho, into this ocean of samsara, which has got the taranga, the waves, taranga malini, which is in the form of jananam and maranam. Therefore, having fallen into that, svayamcha vidvan vinashyati, the vidvan, the jnani, he gets destroyed. Therefore, vidushaha api bhagir mukatvasya janmadi dukkha pravaha patana pravaha pata anapagitvam eva palam natu muktihi. Bhavati. Therefore, even if the person is Vidusha, then Bhagir Mukhatvasya, because he has got the Bhagir Mukhatvam, Bhagir Mukhatvam, Paranchikani Vidhatnat Svayambhu, Parang Prashyati Nantaratman. That is for the Ajnani. Even though here he is a Jnani, this Bhagir Mukhatvam is there. Therefore, he falls into the Janmai Dukkha Pravaha, the flow of this dukkham, which is in the form of janmadi, janmadi dukkha pravaha pata anapayitvam eva palam nato muktihi. So mukti will not be the result iti karana abhavat, because karana abhavat nato muktihi. Karana abhavat. Raga dvesha abhyam vishayeshu pravishtasya vidushaha api vishayabhidhyanam eva prasajjate natu brahmadhyayabhiti sarva anartha moolam vishayabhidhyanam tat karyam cha pratipadayati Bhagavan. The following shloka, Bhagavan pratipadayati, he reveals that what happens to that, even to the vidusha, then if he has got this vishaya vidyanam, which is the cause for sarva anartha moolam, the cause. What happens if the person has got this vishaya vidyanam, and the resultant of that is pratipadayati Bhagavan the following shlokas. So he gives a sangati to the following important shlokas. The following are the important shlokas we will read. Bhashyakaraya says as a connection to the next shloka, he says atha idanim
atha idanim
para bhavishyatah
para bhavishyatah
sarvanarthamoolam idam uchyate
sarvanarthamoolam
idam uchyate. You can see the same words are used, sarvanarthamoolam sarva anartha bijam dhyayato vishayan pumsah
dhyayato vishayan pumsah
sangasteshu pajayate
sangat
sanjayate kamaha
संगायते
कामात् क्रोधो विजायते क्रोधात् भवति सम्मोहः सम्मोहात् स्मृतिर्ब्रह्म
अत
इदानीं परा भविष्यतः सर्व अनर्थमूलम् इदम् उच्यते इदानीं नौ दिभाष्यकार इसेस् सर्व अनर्थमूलम् इदम् उच्यते अनर्थमूलम् बिकॉज द मूलम् इज बिकॉज ऑफ अनर्थ अनर्थ इज दैट विच इज नॉट यूजफुल इनफैक्ट दैट विच इज हार्मफुल harmful to a person. Here the person is a sadhaka, he is a mokshaarthi, for him it becomes anartha, it becomes harmful. So the cause of this spiritual harm for that person, पराभविष्यत् इति उच्यते पराभविष्यतः अनर्थमूलम् इदम् उच्यते सो पराभविष्यतः मीन्स् भविष्य ओके भविष्यतः इस् कृदन्त भविष्य इट् इस् अ शत्रन्त भविष्यतः शत्रन्त वी नो ओन्ली प्रेसेंट पार्टिसिपल future also it can be used ratah sadva by that sutra para bhavishyatah para upasarga bhudhatu bhavishyan bhavishyantau bhavishyantah for future tense also shatru can be used so bhavishya kalika kridanta this is so referring to that person referring to the person Parabhavishyataha means this person, for him, who is going to lose because of this sarva anartha moolam, who will be losing because of this anartha moolam, this anartha which is the cause, idam uchyate, that being said. That is the cause by which the person will lose his spiritual status is being said in the following shlokas. What is that? Dhyayato vishayan pumsaha. Dhyayataha. Okay. Dhyayataha is kshatrantaha. Dhyayataha vishayan pumsaha. Pumsaha referring to the person. So Vishayan Dhyayataha. So the spiritual fall, that's called Parabhavishyaha, the referring to the spiritual fall, the person who is falling spiritually. Spiritual fall. Person, the fall means he has come down from this sadhana, carried over by the Vishyas, therefore it is a spiritual fall. So Parabhavishyataha referring to the spiritual, what could be the spiritual fall of the person, for that, what are the anartha moolam, the root cause of his spiritual fall, that is being said in this shloka. The first one is Dhyayataha Vishayan Pumsaha. The Pumsaha, the person, Vishayan Dhyayataha, he meditates. Meditate means not sitting in meditation. He is dwelling. Jayataha, here it is mean is dwelling on the sense object. Vishaya dhyanam. It is not Brahma dhyanam. It is Vishaya dhyanam. He meditates, that is, he is dwelling on the sense object. That becomes the first fall. His focus is shifted from, as a sadhaka, from Brahma to Vishaya. So, Vishaya dhyanam becomes the first, that is the first anartha. So, anartha, the dhyayataha, vishayan, umsaha. Because of that, what happens? Sangaha upajagate. Sangaha is liking. Liking for what? Teshu. Teshu referring to the sense objects. Because he is dwelling on the sense objects, that is the first step. And the resultant of that is Sangaha. Sangha, the liking for the sense objects. Sangaha upajayate, it is born. So first is dwelling, allowing to enter the mind, that is dwelling, that is dhyanam, vishaya dhyanam. Because of that, now liking, raga, the sangha is developed, that is the second step. And the third step is sangat, sanjayate kamaha. Because of that, sangha, the association with the sense object. May not be the physical association, already you have entertained in the mind, that itself is association, because of which there is now the desire to gain, desire to possess, desire to experience the object, that is kamaha. So, Vishaya Dhyanam has become now Vishaya Kamaha through Sangha. Sangha, raga, liking. So, raga, ragat, kamaha. Then, after kama, what happens? So, kama is there. So, if you have the desire for the object, then there will be attempt to gain the object. So, if the objects are gained, and if it is enjoyed, that is one thing. If the objects are gained and it is enjoyed, then you become a bogi. You become the enjoyer of the objects. But not that every object what you desire, you gain. There are a lot of obstacles even to gain the objects. So when there are obstacles, then what will happen? That kama will be converted to krodha. Anything obstructing that kama becomes a source of krodha, the anger. So, kamat krodha abhijagate. If the desire is not fulfilled, unfulfilled desire will be converted to krodha, the anger. So therefore, all this started for the person who doesn't have shama and dama. First is shama, then dama. Because he allowed the sense organs to enter the mind, he did vishaya dhyanam. That vishaya dhyanam shows that he doesn't have shama. That is, doesn't have say over the mind. He let the mind entertain the thought of the sense objects. Because of that, therefore, sangha with the sense objects, and sangat kamaha, and kama, when it is not fulfilled, converted to krodaha. So, these are the faults, the slips for that person. So, what is the cause? That Vishaya Abhidhyanam, that is, becomes the cause. Vishaya Abhidhyanam becomes the Sarva Anartha Moolam. That is what is said in this shloka. So, then, what happens out of Krodha? Krodhat Bhavati Sammohaha, the next shloka. Krodhat Sambhavati. Kim Sambhavati? Krodhat Sambhavati. Moha, Moha is delusion. Delusion is aviveka. This aviveka is, this delusion is because of aviveka. You lose the power to discriminate. When moha overpowers you, then your viveka, even though you are, yes, you are well informed, well learned, a pandita, viveka will be shaken. You lose viveka, dharma adharma viveka. You lose, here it is not atmanatma viveka. You can take it as dharma adharma viveka. You lose a sense of what adharma is, what dharma is. Therefore, he may engage in adharma activities also because his viveka is stultified because of moha. So, therefore, krodat bhavati sammohaha. Sammohanam happens because of moha. And sammohat, because of sammohana, because of this lack of viveka, what happens to that person? Smriti vibhramaha. He loses his smriti. Smriti means memory. He loses his memory. That is, whatever he studied, whatever shastram he studied, dharma shastram, Vedanta shastram, everything will not be available for that person. That is called brahmaha, smriti vibhramaha, forgetfulness of what has been studied. Smriti, smriti is remembrance. Smriti, brahmaha is loss of remembrance. Remembrance of what? Remembrance of whatever he had learned. So, it's not available for him. Therefore, it is as good as he has not learned. That is called brahmaha, smriti, vibhramaha. Smriti, brahmshat, when the smriti, brahmshat, smriti, brahmshat, because of this smriti, because of this smriti, vibhramaha, because of this loss of the remembrance of what he studied, that is, he's not able to discriminate and understand things clearly because the knowledge is not available for him. So what happens? Buddhi nashaha, buddhi gets destroyed. Buddhi, which is supposed to do the viveka, the vichara, it cannot do its function. Buddhi is lost. Buddhi nashat pranashyati. When buddhi is destroyed, the person is destroyed. The person is not physically destroyed. The person is spiritually destroyed. So, it's a spiritual destruction. It's a spiritual destruction. That's called fall. That is called spiritual fall. Whatever he accomplished through in his life up to this point, everything he will lose, and it's a fall. It's a fall for the person. It's a spiritual fall. For this spiritual fall, what is the cause? The cause is the first step. Vishayan dhyayataha. Vishaya dhyanam becomes the first step. Therefore, that is the cause. That is the first hetu. There itself one has to be cautious. There itself one has to be cautious to cut the entry of the sense objects to the mind. So, therefore, the Shama is important. When Shama is relaxed, that becomes the source for Sarva Anartha Moolam. Because final Anartha Moolam is Pranashyati, Vinashyati, that the person is destroyed, the spiritual destruction of the person, that is the end of the first slip. The first slip is Vishaya Dhyanam. Out of this first slip, the Vishaya Dhyanam, the final result is, the end is Vinashanam, Buddhi Nashat, Vinashanam, that Pranashyati, the person is completely, spiritually destroyed. Spiritual destruction, it results in spiritual destruction. This is the connection. This is the connection. first step, the second step, the third step, and the final step, which is the destruction of the person. So therefore, in the beginning itself, that Vishaya Abhidhyanam, one should not get into this Vishaya Abhidhyanam. That is what Bhagavan says, that Vishaya Abhidhyanam becomes the cause, the moolam for this Sarva Anartha Hetu Parampara. This is the Parampara. This is the Parampara. Parampara means it's a lineage. Here also there is a lineage. Lineage for what? Lineage of fall. Lineage of spiritual fall for the sadhaka. So, therefore, Sarva Anartha Moolam, Anartha Hetu Parampara, Idam Iti Uchyate. The Vashyam that we will see. We will see that in the next class. Om Purnamadah Purnamidam Purnat Purnamudachyate Purnasya Purnamadhaya Purnameva Vashishyate Om Shanti Shanti Shantihi Harihi Om Shri Gurubhyo Namaha Harihi Om
Dhanyavad Aji.
धन्यवाद
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 धन्यवाद धन्यवाद।